Est-ce que vous vous souvenez, chers amis, est-ce que tu te souviens, Nicole, de ce qu'on a vu hier? J'imagine que oui, to add, ajouter. Le j'imagine que oui vous concerne aussi, chers amis, vous l'aurez compris. To subtract, subtract, ok, c'est un à court. Subtract, accent tonique sur la deuxième syllabe. La seconde, pardon, puisqu'il n'en a que deux. Soustraire, to add, to subtract. To multiply, multiply, multiplier, and to divide, diviser. Donc Nicole, en plus ça tombe bien, Nicole is a teacher, et non pas Nicole is teacher, ok, is a teacher. C'est parfait, elle vous a indiqué toutes ces opérations, toutes celles qu'on a vues hier vous permettront de faire toutes celles-ci aujourd'hui, mais on a rajouté un second exercise pour que vous puissiez vous exercer et que vous puissiez acquérir en quelque sorte, au moins que vous en souveniez, mais ce serait top si vous puissiez acquérir, si vous pouviez, pardon, mon Dieu, si vous pouviez acquérir des automatismes et savoir exprimer en anglais à l'oral, évidemment, ce type d'opération qui reste, ma foi, assez simple parce que même pour les nuls en maths comme moi, j'arrive à les faire, ok? So now it's time to speak English, guys. Mais avant, vous avez encore deux occasions, deux sessions de formation gratuites qui vous attendent. Donc, il y en a une qui doit être, si je ne me trompe pas, demain, le 20 novembre. Donc, mardi 20 novembre à 15h, Nicole. Mais aussi jeudi à 20h. Et ça s'appelle le plan précis pour parler anglais dans les semaines qui viennent. C'est fait pour vous. Aider à reprendre l'anglais ou à continuer si vous êtes déjà en train d'essayer ou de simplement vous améliorer en anglais. On va parler compréhension, Nicole. On va parler prononciation et on va parler pratique de l'anglais. Les places sont limitées, donc faites vite. Mais surtout, je vous demanderai vraiment de bien respecter ça. Ne vous inscrivez pas aux deux sessions puisque les deux sessions sont identiques. Ça dure 1 à 2 heures. On est en direct. Inscrivez-vous à une seule. Donc, soit mardi à 15h, soit jeudi à 20h. Pour ce faire, chers amis, c'est très simple. Vous cliquez non pas ici, mais bien au-dessus. Il y a une espèce de « i » là-haut. Ou dans le lien, si vous ne le trouvez pas, ou sous la vidéo, pardon, sur le lien. Okay, parce qu'on clique sur quelque chose en bon français. In English too, we click on a link. Right?
Yes.
To click on a link below the video. Okay? Bah, tenez, ce sera l'expression bonus. To click, sorry guys, like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
On, of course. On link, cliquez sur un lien. Voilà, ça c'est assez facile, vous pouvez retenir link. C'est intéressant, lien, link. It's easy to remember, guys.
Click
for
on
you.
The link.
The link, yes. The link below the video. Could I say on a link?
Yeah, if it's not specific.
Okay.
Yeah.
Donc si c'est pas spécifique, de manière générale, on a link. So I'm not saying to you that this is this one or that one. On the link below the video. Celui-ci, c'est spécifique, donc c'est on the link. Mm-hmm. Okay? Thank you very much, Nicole.
You're welcome.
No. I'm wondering, what is that? 2 plus 2 fois 3? How could we say that in English, guys?
Let's see. 2 plus 2 in the parentheses.
In the what?
The parentheses.
Ooh, could you please spell it for us or maybe write it for us?
Parentheses.
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 Okay, brackets?
These are parentheses and these are brackets.
Ok, faites bien la différence. Brackets.
Parentheses. Brackets also.
C'est aussi la collade et le crochet, ok? Brackets, parentheses.
Ok. So, we have 2 plus 2 in parentheses times 3. What does that equal? I hope I get it right. I hope you get it right. 4 times 3 equals 12.
12, okay. Times, like the newspaper, okay?
Okay, next one. Again, in parentheses, we have 4 plus 4 divided by 3. Okay? So we have 4 divided by 3.
Which is actually...
It's a fraction.
A fraction.
We'll talk in about fractions. So it would equal 4 over 3, which equals 1 and 1 third.
Which is 1.333333 and so on.
Yes.
To the infinite.
Infinity, yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Now this one is a fraction multiplied by a whole number.
A fraction.
A fraction.
A fraction, not a fraction, okay?
Fraction.
Avec la gorge, guys. Fraction. Mm-hmm. Fraction. Mm-hmm. And not fraction, but fraction. Fraction.
Fraction, yep. This is a fraction, and this is a whole number.
A what?
A whole number.
What is that?
A whole number.
Donc, un nombre entier. Vous l'avez compris, j'en suis sûr. Okay. Whole, and not whole, okay? Whole.
Yeah, not whole. You don't want to pronounce the W.
Donc, nombre entier. Fractions.
Fraction.
Les fractions.
Times a whole number. So in the United States, we usually put a 1 underneath and we multiply across.
To multiply across.
Multiply across. So we have 4 times 5 is 20. 4 times 1 is 4. And of course, 20 divided by 4 is 5.
No, 5. Oh my God. I'm just joking, of course, guys. So I want you to understand something. Nicole, I got a question for you. Mm-hmm. What is that? Is it a whole number? Is this one a whole number? Is this one a whole number?
If we have 5.2, the 5 is a whole number. The 2 is the fraction. If we just have the 4 there, that's a whole number by itself.
Okay.
And it becomes that or that.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. Bon, regardez. Super simple. 4 tout seul, nombre entier, whole number. For example, 4 divided by 2, fraction. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a fraction. And this one, for example, 4.2. This is a decimal, mm-hmm. right?
Yes.
Am I right?
It's a decimal.
Okay, yeah. I'm a good student.
Very good student.
I hope you do agree, guys. Come on, please. Yeah, okay. Thank you very much.
I think so. Okay. Now, this one, it's difficult because you have to do, in the parentheses, you have a big number. So 1 plus 97 is 98. 98 times 2, oops.
Easy.
98 times 2 is, I have to figure it out.
Okay, I can help you if you need some help.
We have 98 two times, okay, 196. So I'm not very good at math, so I have to do it out.
You can take the eraser. It's right there.
There it is. So 9 times 98 times 2 equals 196.
Equals.
Equals.
S mm-hmm. de la troisième personne du quoi? Du présent simple. Exactement.
Okay. And last one here we have.
Oh, wait. I got a question for you.
Sure.
Very important. Maybe not very important, but maybe you're wondering. Is it 196 or 196?
So 196.
Not 196. Mm-mm. 196. And
196.
You must basically write it like that. Okay?
Yeah.
96.
Yeah. If we're speaking fast, we'll say 196, but The proper way is 196 or 196.
So it's either 100 or 800.
800, yeah.
Okay. What is this thing in English?
It's called a hyphen.
A what?
A hyphen.
Could you please write it for us or maybe spell it?
Hyphen.
Hyphen?
Hyphen.
Hyphen. Trait d'union. Okay, guys? So and you need one here.
Yes. So for our big numbers, we use hyphens a lot because 96 go together. So we don't want to separate the two words into two separate words. It's one word, really, but we need to distinguish the 9 and the 6, so we put a hyphen in there.
45, you need a hyphen.
Yeah.
I don't know, 26, you need a hyphen, yeah. And so on.
Okay.
Last one.
Here, pretty easy. In the parentheses, we have 19 minus 17, which is 2, times 15.
Too easy. Sorry.
Equals 30. Okay.
Are you sure?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, I think so too. So 2 times 50?
15.
15. So, allons, ilons.
Yeah.
Okay.
So be very careful when you're pronouncing the end. 50 and 15. 15.
Okay, donc faites vraiment le ilon quand c'est
yeah.
15, 14, 16, 17, yes. 13, 18, 19,
yeah.
And 20.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, mm-hmm. Nicole. I really think it is helpful for you guys. So if you have any questions, if you wanna, you know, ask anything to Nicole, please just write something down there under the video, below the video. And I'm going to answer you, or maybe Nicole could also answer you.
Yes.
And guys, keep learning English. I do think you are on the right track. So to be on the right track, être sur le bon chemin,
yeah.
Si je peux dire.
And the numbers and all of the math terms, for me, learning French is very important. So definitely keep yourself familiar with these terms. Over here, we have fractions and decimals, and you know the conversion over here. And I know that in Europe, you guys use the comma and not the decimal.
Exactly. To be on the right track, être sur la bonne piste, sur le bon chemin, vous faites exactement ce qu'il faut. Continuez, keep learning, guys, on a daily basis, tous les jours, every day. This is extremely important. Do you want to add something, Nicole?
Continuez, j'espère vous avez continué, appris les numéros terminologies.
J'espère que vous allez continuer à apprendre les chiffres.
Les chiffres, les chiffres améliorer.
Pour améliorer.
Pour améliorer. Votre anglais.
Votre anglais, ok. Bon, vous voyez, Nicole, elle apprend le français, elle n'a pas peur, elle essaye. You're trying, right?
Yes, j'essaie beaucoup.
Ok, so if you don't try, you don't improve. Ok,
c'est
si
vrai.
Vous essayez pas, vous n'allez pas vous améliorer ça. You have to keep it in mind. Keep it in mind. This is extremely important, guys. So, again, thank you very much. Talk to you very soon, guys. Talk to you tomorrow. Talk to you below the video in the comments, okay, in the comments section. If you need anything, drop me a line or write it down below, okay? Thank you. Bye-bye. Talk to you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Thank you very much, Nicole.